So, three-color scumble worked through here, and I'm going to do a three-color gradient. And the gradient is, again, it's a blend of all three colors, but in this case, it's much more mechanical. There's an ombre of the three colors. I'm going to go pink, light pink here, a yellow in the middle, and the red towards this side. And like a slow, even distribution of color and transition of color as it goes from one to the next to the next. To work with the lightest color first. And since I'm using three colors, I'm going to do about a third of it in one color here. Couple of specks of red that splashed over, and it's giving me some additional pink that's flowing into this. I'm just going to smooth it out. It's not too bad. This brushed gradient or ombre gives a nice transition. Technique-wise, I could do this with a spray or spatter as well, but in this case, I'm using it as a brush. And blend this all through. So I've got one, two, a third of this color. Nice and even. Clean out my brush. All right, and go into the shell. In the middle. End up with three stripes growing across. And again, working pretty fast before it all dries. And also, if I was having difficulty with it drying on me too quickly, I would get a spray bottle and lay that in. More, another third. All right. And that's red. Intense red here. Okay, even it out here. Right. I think I will get a water bottle. So just got a water bottle, spray water bottle with a little bit of water in it. And I'm gonna just do a light mist on this. No puddling, it's just giving me a little bit of light mist on top of it. Using some clean water here to try to get relatively clear, clean brush.
Okay.
And back up and through. Got a long extension on my arm. I am gonna get clean, more clean water. Red is very aggressive and is showing back up, hard to get out. So cleaned it out with a little water. And again, to this transition. Try to gradient one color at a time. I go into the red, everything is gonna turn kind of pink. So try to bring up some of the yellow back into this transition area. Okay. So ideally with this kind of transition, I'd like it to go from one color and start adding the other color. Won't be able to see really where one color starts and the other color stops. So as we're going to do this yellow here. And I think I'm done with that. I'm gonna start into the red and try to draw red up into the yellow. But not too far. I don't want to obliterate the beautiful yellow. Or I'll lose some of the beauty that the red itself has. I'm gonna quit. Seriously, I'm gonna quit. world. So I've got pure red here, going into the blend, forming an orange, going into the pure yellow, going into a light yellow, into this white, blending into yellow-white, and then to a pure white, pinkish-white here. And it does have a kind of brushed landscape kind of feel, sunset kind of feel with these colors. Nice transition. I've got some contamination here with a couple of splats. I'm not going to worry about that or try to overwork them. The only thing that would, again, with this is keeping it wet as I'm trying to work through my blending. Don't over blend it, and we're done. So I've got this as a three color gradient, and then this one as the three color scumble.
Okay.